हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हाउ आर यू? ओके चिल्ड्रन, टुडे नाउ वी आर स्टार्टिंग न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज रिलेटेड विथ इरेशनल नंबर. चिल्ड्रन, दिस इरेशनल नंबर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक चिल्ड्रन, सो लेट अस पे अटेंशन केयरफुली चिल्ड्रन. सो चिल्ड्रन, बिफोर यू स्टार्ट दिस टॉपिक टुडे, यू सब्सक्राइब दिस चैनल. Children, we are familiar with natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, Q, that is rational number. Now, children, our topic, that is real numbers. Okay, these real numbers consists of two types of numbers. First is rational number and this is irrational number. Now children, rational number, you know that it is of the form P by Q. So number which are not having P by Q form. Okay. A number which cannot be expressed in this form, that is known as irrational number. And a number can be expressed in this form, that is known as rational number. Rational number and irrational number combined to both, we combining and we have a collection that is known as real number, and for that symbol is R, children. So here today's topic is irrational number. Let us take some example. Root 2, root 7, cube root of 2. This type of numbers are known as irrational number. Or we can say that this type of numbers we cannot express in this form P by Q. So now children, question comes that how to represent these numbers on a number line. Children, this is our number line. So on this number line, we want to represent such type of numbers on this number line. So let us study how to represent these numbers on the number line. Now children, before we proceed to this topic, we must know Pythagoras rules. That actually you are going to study or you will study in 10th standard. But here I have to give introduction about this Pythagoras theorem. Then only you can do this type of problems. So first let us do some examples regarding Pythagoras theorem. Now children, this Pythagoras is a name of mathematician. He derived this concept for right angle triangle. This is right angle triangle where B is right angle. Now this is AC side. So AC square equal to AB square plus BC square. Suppose we take AB measurement 1 and BC measurement 1. Now put this value here, 1 square plus 1 square. 1 square is what? 1 only. This 1 square is 1 only. 1 plus 1 equal to 2. So AC is equal to root 2. Children, this is AC square. Now we take both these sides square root. So this 2 we remove here and here square root sign will come. So AC equal to root 2. This we have derived. Now children, take another example. Same type of figure. Right angle triangle. ABC. Suppose this is 2. This is 3. Here is a question mark. formula is same formula, AC square equal to AB square plus BC square. AB square is what? 2 square. BC square is what? 3 square. 2 to 4. 3 square is 9. 13. So what will come AC equal to? It will be root 13. Now children, let us take one more example. And now I am taking this example. This we will use in next calculation. A, B, C. Suppose AB is 1 and root 2. Let us AB take root 2 and BC equal to 1. What about this AC? Formula same. AC square equal to AB square plus BC square. AB is equal to what? Root 2 square. BC equal to what? 1 square. Now children, very important rule. Square root sign and this 2. If you simplify this, answer will be this 2. Okay? And 1 square is 1. This is 3. Now children, remember forever. Any square. Suppose it is 5 square. So 5 square is 5. Suppose it is 3 square. Root 3 square. It would be 3. So remember this rule. Children, we will study this in next part. Next topic in this chapter only. But time being, you accept it. Now 2 plus 1 equal to 3. This is what? AC square. So AC equal to what? It is root 3. Now see children, here some examples I have given you. Pause the video or take screenshot of this video and you can solve this problem. Find out AC everywhere. Okay children, now let us proceed next topic. Now children, question is, it is your example 3. Locate root 2 on the number line. So first we draw children one line. Okay. Now somewhere here you take 0. Then from this point to here we draw 3 cm. So put your scale. This is 0 here. 1, 2, 3. So this is 0.1. So this length is 3 cm. Now here you have to draw exactly perpendicular to this another 3 cm line like this. Okay children. Here you call it point A. This point is B. Now join B and O children. So that I am joining here. Okay children. So children, this is our number line. On this number line, we have constructed right angle triangle. Now children, here we will first apply our Pythagoras rule. Let us understand. Now children, in some examples you have done, in that you took right angle triangle this way. Okay. But in figure we have right angle triangle this way. It makes no difference children. Okay. So here is point B. This point is A. This is O. Now this length in right angle triangle, you know that it is known as hypotenuse. So OB square equal to OA square plus AB square. Okay children. Now see, suppose here it is B, O and A. So what you are writing? OB square equal to AB square and OA square. Same thing is here. Now children, this is 1, this is 1. You may have questioned that here though we have taken 3, 3. But children, here we are, one point we are mentioning that, and that is 1 unit is equal to 3 centimeter. Okay, so this OA is 3 centimeter, but it is actually our 1 unit. Okay, here this is 1 unit. Clear? Now children, 1 unit is this, 1 unit is this. So here 1 we have taken. So this is 1 square plus 1 square, 1 plus 1. Already you have done it. So here just very speedily I am writing to save our time children. OB square equal to root 2. So this part, this OB, that is our root 2. Now children, we have to use pair of compass. And take pair of compass in your hand. Put this metal point at O and pencil point at B. Now children, do this way. Okay. So here we are getting a point. This point is known as, that is point is root 2. This starting point is 1. This is our 0, 0. This is 1, root 2 children. Okay. So it is very easy method. Here what we have done? Locate root 2 on the number line. So here we have obtained a point root 2. Or you can say that here you just mentioned point C. So this OC length is root 2 length. So we have obtained a point root 2. Root 2 is irrational number on the number line children. Okay. Now let us take next sum. Now children, question is locate root 3 on number line. Take 1 unit equal to 3 centimeter. So here first step is we draw a line. We call it as a number line. Arrow. Somewhere you take here 0 or you can say it is O or 0. Now children, 3 centimeter measure from here 0. This point is 3 centimeter. Now from here keep your scale in such a way that here it makes right angle. So this is another 3 centimeter. This is 1 unit. This is also 1 unit. Now join, call it this point A, this point B, join OB. Okay. Now children, in previous sum, what we have done that you know, this is 1, this is 1. So this measurement we had, it was root 2. And from this point, we constructed this root 2. So up to this, once again I did because we need it. So this is root 2. Now children, second step for this root 3 is keep your scale exactly perpendicular and from this point you draw one line this way, root 3. Now join O to this point C. Okay. Clear children? And now put here your scale, joint this thing. So this point is your root 3. Now children, let us do calculation for this root 3. How we have obtained. Now children, see. Now see, OD, this is, this point is D, this point is E. So OD is equal to what? Root 2 measurement. DC is equal to 1 unit. This is root 2 unit, this is root 1 unit. And OC we want to find. So apply Pythagoras rule. OC square equal to OD square plus dc square. Children, this measurement is root 2, children. This is OD. So OD is equal to root 2 square, DC equal to 1 square. Now root 2 square is 2 plus 1, 3. So OC equal to what? Root 3. So children, this root 3, so this OC, this is root 3. Now from this point, with the help of pair of compass, we have obtained root 3. Clear? Now by this way you can proceed here once again. You can take one more line like this, 3 cm. See. Take your pair of compass and put here pair of compass. Oh, sorry. So here you will get line this way. So this point will be root 4. Now children, whether you are getting root 4 exact or not, so can you guess it? How to find? We know that root 4 is equal to what? Equal to 2. So this measurement is 1. If you measure from A to this point, suppose we call it point F. A to F you measure, and if you are getting 2 units, means 2 units means what? 1 unit is 3. So 2 units means what? 6 cm. If you are getting O to F 6 cm, then your answer is right. You have not made any mistake. You have done correctly. Again you do put your pair of compass here, I mean scale here, and take 3 cm line. Take pair of compass here. Do line. Okay. So now this point you are getting root 5. So if it is asked that construct root 5, so by this way you can construct root 5. So children, here I did not draw this line. But that is, that you can understand, this line and this line. Okay. So now children, this root 5. So here, construction of root 2, root 3, root 4, root 5. Further you can proceed root 6, root 7. Only one thing, keep it in mind that when you are doing this line or this line or this line, it should be exactly perpendicular to this. Perpendicular means here 90 degree. And join with this point. So from this point it should come. It should not spread over here. Okay. Then this is root 2, root 3, root 4, root 5. So ultimately we have obtained root 5. This is one of the questions in our exercise also that we will see. Now children, in textbook, in example 4, it is given that locate root 3 on the number line. So here they are doing little bit different way. First part it is clear for us that here 0, B, A, now 1 unit, and root 2 unit. Now children, what for root 3, what they are doing? You just turn your textbook this way. Now you can see that this is OA is one of the side. Here they are putting scale in such a way that here it is a right angle. So this is root 2, this is 1, and join this root 3. Now take pair of compass and put here pair of compass, metal point it at O, pencil point at D, and do this way like this. Okay, so then you are getting root 3 here. So this is known as spiral method. So by this way also you can do it. But actually what happened children, when it is root 3, root 4, and if you are not getting exactly here 90, because you don't have enough practice. So sometimes you will do wrong answer. So children, I taught another method. So in exam, you can do either this method or the method just now I taught. Any method you can use it. Don't worry. Both the methods are okay. So whichever method you feel easy, by that way you can solve it. Now children, let us start exercise 1.2. State whether the following statements are true or false. Justify your answer. Every irrational number is a real number. Children, it is correct statement. Okay. Every irrational number is a real number. It is true statement. Okay. Next one. Every point on the number line is of the form root m, where m is a natural number. Now children, this is false statement. Okay. Every point on the number line is of the form root m, where m is a natural number. Suppose we take number line. Let us understand. And here I am taking number 2, number 3, number 4. So now children, you may have answered that root 2, this is nothing but root 4. Root 3, this is nothing but root 9. Root 4, this is nothing but root 16. So here 4, 9, 16, all are m. All are positive. So we at a first reading, we may give answer that okay, it is right. But now see, between 2 and 3, suppose we take 1.5. Here we take 1.5. This is square root of 2.25. And 2.25 is not natural number. Okay, children. What I did here, I took 1.5 from here between 2 and 3. Exactly we take this point, so it is 1.5. So this is a number. Now this is a square root of this number, 2.25. Now 2.25 is not natural number. So here it is given that where m is natural number. So this is false. Next one. Every real number is an irrational number. No, every real number is not. So third one is false. One example is enough. Suppose we take one number. Here it is given. No, every real number is an irrational number. Suppose 7 is real number, but 7 is not irrational number. So it is false one. Now children, next question. Are the square root of all positive integers irrational? If not, give an example of the square root of number that is rational number. So children, here let us take one example. Square root of positive integers. Suppose I take 4. Answer I am getting 2. So 2 is not irrational number. Okay. Suppose I take 9. So I am getting 3. 3 is not irrational number. So answer is no. Are the square roots of all positive integers irrational? So these are not irrationals. So answer is no. Now question third one. So that root 5 can be represented on the number line. Children, you can do by this way spiral method, or the way I taught, by that way also you can do it, children. Now see children, here already we have done. By this way also you can do it once again. Draw this way line. First you have to construct root 2, then next step would be root 3, then root 4, then root 5. So children, today it is enough for you, and today's homework is you write down homework, pause the video and note down it. Now children, here is your homework. There are 3 questions. For each one you do separate work. Children, for homework and for regular work, one fair notebook you have to make it. Last moment, I am reminding you that If you have not subscribed this channel, you subscribe it, because whenever I put this video on YouTube, immediately you will get it. Okay, children. Thank you. Good day. Bye.